From One of One Production Studios, broadcasting from NYC, you are listening to Unexpected Success with your host, Joy.
Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Unexpected Success with your host, me, Joy. Hey, in the studio today, we have Edwina Kulego.
Hello.
Hi, I'm so happy to have you here.
Thank you. It's
awesome to be here. I'll get into how I met Edwina, but I'm so inspired by her. She's a CEO of Essentials by Edwina, which is a vegan makeup collection, right? Mm-hmm. And you're also the manager of international business development at UBM Fashion Group.
Yes.
And you're also an author.
Yeah, most recently.
Right, you have a chapter in the book, The Better Business Book, which provides inspirational and business lessons for entrepreneurs, right?
Yeah.
And this is like a recent, was it recently released?
Yeah, it's actually officially releasing November 27th. So
oh,
it's
wow.
an exclusive so, drop.
Oh, and this is my copy, right?
Yes, that's
I
your copy.
You.
I need to sign
Yay!
It for you.
Okay, this is awesome. So yeah, and I kind of flipped through it a little bit. And mm-hmm. I think that's a lot of the, you can use it. A
yes.
lot of the lessons can be used. So I'm so happy to have you here.
Thank you for having me. It's nice to be here.
And we met at Rebecca Allen's house.
Yes.
And Rebecca Allen was on the podcast. I met her. And Rebecca Allen, just to remind everyone, she has the line of footwear, right? For
yes.
all colors
all
of nude, all shades of nude, which
yes.
is awesome.
That's actually how we connected. So I
oh, really?
Found her online on Instagram and I was like, this is so cool. It's similar to the concept of our latest collection, the Legacy Collection. So I shouted her out on Instagram and she reached out and she was like, thanks so much. I'd love to connect. And that's,
oh, that's
how
great.
We
oh,
met.
Oh, I love that. Right.
Yeah.
And this is a Legacy commercial. I'm sorry, collection, right?
Yes.
And I love this ad. I told
Yay!
You that like four times.
All my girls.
Times. I love it. No, all the major influencers. So, huge fan. And you
Thank
have such
you.
An amazing story. So, you know, again, the purpose of the podcast is kind of just to tell your path, mm-hmm. right? Your entrepreneurial path
yeah.
and how you went for it, right? Because I think that it's pretty atypical for an individual to be able to come up with their own makeup line, right?
Yeah. It's been an awesome journey.
And you weren't born in the States.
No, I was actually born in Sweden, one of the coldest countries in the world.
I've never been to Sweden.
It's stunning. I think it's ranked one of the most peaceful countries in the world. It's very, our health, it's kind of like Canada. Healthcare system is awesome. It's super
oh, wow.
clean. It's a great country. It's very small, very neat.
And which city did you grow up in?
I grew up in the south in Malmo, which is the third capital. Shout out to Malmo.
I mean, I'm asking like I'm familiar.
No. Stockholm is the capital, which is
right.
what most people know Stockholm. I grew up in the south, which is really close to Copenhagen in Denmark, which
okay.
has become like a hot city to visit now.
Yeah. I'm a huge tennis fan. So like I know like Wozniacki is mm-hmm. from Denmark. And
yeah.
So I know like tennis players.
That's
like,
okay.
And,
you know
but I don't
know.
That's it. That's all I got.
Yeah.
But okay. Mm-hmm. All right. And how was it growing up there?
It was really good. I had a great childhood. I mean, I was obviously being African in Sweden.
You're Ghanaian.
Yes.
Okay.
Originally from Ghana. Shout out to Ghana. I never lived in Ghana, but I would go there and visit. I'm very connected to my Ghanaian culture. I speak the languages. But growing up in Sweden was awesome. I went to really good schools. Again, the educational system is great there. There was a small community of like Africans, so we were really close. And
fascinating.
It's a great place.
And what brought your family there, like how did they end up settling in?
My grandfather he migrated to Germany actually and worked there, and then eventually he had my father come out and join him, and then they went to Sweden, and he sent for my mom, which was his high school sweetheart.
Oh,
and
oh, yeah,
they ended up in Malmo, which is crazy because it's so far from Africa,
right?
And, you know,
right, yeah.
And if you think about the contrast, it's like where Ghana's right on the equator. It's like one of the warmest destinations in the world, and we end up in like the coldest in Scandinavia.
You made it.
Yes, we
right,
made
and
it.
You made it.
We made it out.
And so what did your parents, are your parents entrepreneurs or?
Yes, both of them actually.
Okay.
My mother was the first woman of color to open up a beauty supply store for African Afro hair.
Oh, wow.
Hair products and skincare in Sweden. in the south of Sweden.
And there's a good following there. So I'm like trying to see this, right? I'm trying to picture this African community in Sweden.
Yes,
right?
There are. I mean, there are a lot of, you know, East Africans. You have like a huge population from Somalia, Eritrea, Ethiopia. On the west side, lots of Nigerians, Ghanaians, Ivory Coast, Ivorians. But yeah, I mean, they all kind of settled there, and it was just hard for people to find hair products, you know?
Yeah, I'm sure. I mean, I'm sure the market was, your mom's a genius.
Right, there was nothing there, and what happened was they would have to go to, like, London in the UK, where there were more black people, to get products.
Right.
Or she would have to go to Amsterdam, so eventually she started traveling to those places and buying products back, selling them. She would, you know, go back and forth, and then she was like, there's a real business
behind this. There's a
real
market for it, right.
So she opened up, at that time it was called Touch of Class, and we've been in business for maybe 18 years now. Shout out to my mom.
Shout out to mom, the original.
Right. Yes, and now it's called InStyle Hair and Beauty, and it's located in Malmö at Mellevonsgatan 27.
Now that's something, that's a different street.
Yes, that's a Swedish street.
Awesome, awesome. Yeah. And your dad was an entrepreneur?
Yes, entrepreneur as well. He is the man behind Kulego Fashion, which was one of the first urban fashion destinations in southern Sweden. So he used to come out to the U.S. and buy like FUBU, you know, back in the day when that was popping, Sean John. All those brands,
and
urban brands.
And he had a storefront?
He had a storefront.
Oh, wow.
I think he was in business for about 10 years, and then eventually he decided to shut it down.
Right.
I think he was hoping my brother would take over the business, but he went into music, and was popping off. But yeah, I've been blessed.
Yeah, we discussed your brother. Shout out to your brother.
Yeah, shout out to Lazy.
And he's he's a producer.
He is. So he produces. He's a songwriter, and he's also a 3-time Grammy nominated artist.
Oh my
goodness! So across the board, he just
does. He need a lawyer?
You know what? He might.
Let's talk offline, right?
Okay, yes, let's do that for sure.
I'm retired, but man, he sounds like he might be it. So
listen,
if he's a lawyer,
he is family, and I am biased, but he's wonderful, and he spent 2 months in New York working with various artists, and he comes home like in the morning because he's working in the studio all night, and he's like, Eddie, you got to listen to this song. He calls me Eddie. And they're amazing, like the composition, the thought behind it, how he samples other tracks. And, you know, the music world is dear to me because my dad was a DJ, and that's kind of how we fell in love with it.
Yeah.
But he understands music in a completely different way. And I'm just amazed at what
he's able to do. I'm sure all the different backgrounds, right? I feel like the fact that he has, like, he grows up in Sweden, right?
Yes.
I mean, it's so many influences that
absolutely
the average person just doesn't have.
No, and he grew up in London, too. So he spent 6 years there. My mom was like, look, you got to get your together.
He
went to London to live with my uncle for 6 years. And he got introduced to, like, the UK artists there and the influence, so garage, drum and bass, and I feel like that has also helped develop his sound, which is really unique.
Oh, that's awesome. That's awesome. So entrepreneurs all around.
Yes.
I mean, so do you have fear? I mean, it seems like you, even your brother, it sounds like he just goes for it.
Yes.
So it seems like it's kind of
in your blood. Yeah, I think that we've been fortunate enough to see the successes of our parents and also the failures, right? So you were like working in my mom's store, you know, some months we didn't meet our quota, or, you know, something would happen. Someone broke into the store and, you know,
stole
a bunch of stuff. So I've seen her go through so much adversity in business, you know, being shut down and having just people not believe in her vision, and, you know, having perseverance, I think, is what has helped me and my brother, because we've been able to see, okay, mom fell down, but she got back up.
Right.
So fear, I mean, I think we all have fear at some point, but it's all about how you deal with it.
Right.
Do you face it head on, or do you sit back?
Right.
And I think that's a huge difference from people who end up becoming super successful and others that kind of wish they went for it.
Did you always know that you wanted to be, I guess the beauty background comes from mom, right?
Yes.
So did you always know you wanted to have a career in beauty, or is it?
No.
Oh, no.
Never.
how did that come about?
It was, you know, it was basically a connection that I made with Nicole, who is the CEO of Selfie Cosmetics. So
okay, so you have a partnership with...
I do, with okay. Selfie. Shout out to Selfie.
Shout out to Selfie.
So I've been, you know, I've been in... I moved to New York studying at Berklee College, and when I started, I thought I wanted to study fashion. So I took up fashion marketing and management, and then I realized I don't want to do this. Like, I want to do business. I'm a business person.
You're a business person,
but
right.
I love fashion. So what I did was I changed my major to international business, and then I took all of my electives and I did all my internships in fashion. So I worked for Andy Hilfiger at Tommy Hilfiger.
Oh, wow.
I was a fashion intern at Essence Magazine.
Oh, so much fun.
So much fun. Oh, amazing place. And imagine growing up in Sweden with right. nothing but Caucasian people.
Right.
And then coming into an amazing city, New York, and then getting my first internship at Essence, where I saw these beautiful black women making moves, you know, executives.
Yeah.
I never saw women of color in high positions. I never had a black doctor, never had a black teacher.
So there's none of that in Sweden, huh?
Now it's changing. So it's actually, I went home and I had a dentist appointment and my dentist was black. And I was like, hey girl, like I was just beaming and she probably thought I was nuts.
Right.
But when I was growing up, that wasn't a thing.
Well, I mean, I think, you know, growing up, I mean, I grew up, I'm a little bit older than you, but no, I didn't have any black doctors or dentists
well,
either.
There you go.
Right.
Yeah.
So, I mean, even, and I'm from here, I'm from New York.
Right.
But, I mean, I think it was pretty atypical.
Absolutely.
Even here, mm-hmm. right, depending on what neighborhood you were in. And now it's become a lot more prevalent.
It is.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful thing to see. So Essence was like, wow. You know, I would call my mom and be like, this happened at work today.
And I met
Mickey Taylor and she's amazing.
These were
icons.
Yeah,
she would have Essence magazines in her store.
Shout out to Mickey. Mickey did the show.
She was on.
Yeah, she was on, I guess, maybe a couple months ago.
That's amazing.
And even Catherine was crying. So
she's just a force. She's a force.
Yeah, she definitely is.
So I did those internships in fashion and then... I landed a job as an executive assistant.
Okay.
First, I was an intern to Sharifa Murdoch, who helped me get into the trade show business. So shout out to her. And then I worked as an executive assistant and kind of worked my way up into the role that I'm in now.
Right.
But in conclusion, I never thought of beauty would be something I would fall into. But I met Nicole, who's the CEO of Selfie.
Right.
And we had two friends in common that were like, you guys should get together. My hairdresser was like, do you know Nicole from Selfie? I feel like you should know her. You should meet her. And then I had another friend who was like, hey, do you know Nicole from Selfie? I was like, no, you're
the second
person.
Isn't it so interesting, though, that how people kind of like, you kind of get these nudges. And
yes.
People keep on like, nudging you about someone and you're like, yeah, no, I've heard about this person, but what is it? Right. And you meet them, you're like, oh, I should know you.
Right. That's exactly what happened. And I was like, two people have nudged me. I'm going to contact this woman and we're going to get together. And she was like, I've heard so much about you as well. So we sat down, we had dinner in Brooklyn and we just talked about life, about children. At that time I wasn't a mother. You know, we talked about family, what inspires us. And I was thinking, She wanted to connect because she needed advice on taking the Selfie brand global or just business advice because I do consulting as well. Yeah.
Oh, so you're a consultant. So just wait. So pause. So
sorry.
Side note, right? So Edwina does consulting for international business. If you have a brand,
yes,
that is currently say stateside, but you want to, you know, expand into international markets, which everybody should want to do, right?
Absolutely. There's so much opportunity.
Now, how can people engage you for that service?
EdwinaKulego.com.
EdwinaKulego.com, right?
Yes.
So if you want to engage the services of making your business go international.
Go global, right.
Okay, so I'm sorry.
Yes,
then,
no.
Now we can go back.
Thank you. Thanks for that. I need to do that more. I need to be more intentional with what I do. So I met Nicole. We talked and I was like, okay, I'm sure, you know, I was thinking of ways to help her.
Right.
And she was like, well, wait, no, I want to do like a collaboration with you. And I was like, me? No, I was like, no.
Yeah.
She was like, yeah, I'd love, I mean, you're a global woman, you're an influencer, you know a lot of people, you travel all the time, you'd be a perfect profile for a collaboration. And she worked with like Claudia Jordan. She's worked with, you know, a lot of like reality stars, celebrities.
Right. So she has reach.
She does.
But she doesn't have the international reach.
Right. So that was kind of the soft spot for both of us. But initially I was like, well, I'm not really, you know, I'm not that big. Me thinking like I'm not a celeb. Isn't I don't put so myself out there.
And that's the thing. It's like, it's so how we kind of sell ourselves short.
Absolutely.
Right. We'll be like, oh no, we can't. I'm not that big of a deal. Why would I want to do that? Uh-huh. Right.
And it turned out to be really, really successful. But she was like, no, I want to work with micro influencers. I want to reach real women.
Right.
And which is why this campaign was so important for us, because we wanted to use not the typical models, but we wanted to use real women with real stories, real entrepreneurs. And that's what this was all about. So she was like, I wanted to work with you.
People. So yeah. So I don't have this all the way. So you have Rosie.
Rachel, Rosie Philidor, Rachel, Ursula Stevens, Bianca, Brianna, and Sharifa. So these are all women who, from different walks of life, some in fashion, others in marketing, creative fields, business women who I know personally. Yeah. So I wanted it to have a personal connection to me because it's still my brand.
Of course.
The first collection we did, which is the Essentials collection, I was like the face of the brand, which was fun because I'm introducing something that's mine.
And then you had like the red, I saw yes. some of your, I've been stalking you. So. I went through and saw some of your like the reds yes. and some of the campaigns.
We have the Lala, which is like a bright red, the Shiraz, which is a wine color, and then the Noga, which is a nude, which led to this collection.
Okay.
So we found that a lot of women of color were like, I love the Noga. It's such a beautiful, rich
Everybody wants the perfect nude.
Yes, and it's hard for us.
It's so hard to find it. I mean, you have to typically mix. So I typically have always mixed.
Yes.
Right?
You have to keep mixing. And I'm like, why do we have to keep mixing when others find their colors like that?
Like, they go to store, this works.
Yes. Done. And there are other brands that are also focusing on expanding the ranges for beauty, like Fenty, for example, which I think is amazing. But there needs to be more. And I remember when I was telling, you know, friends and other contacts that I was launching this, they're like, well, why would you do a beauty line? There's so many other beauty lines out there. And I'm like, no, that's what we're doing wrong.
Right.
We have to find a need and then fill that need.
Absolutely. I completely agree.
Yeah.
I understand. Like, I come from the age where I went to Hampton University in Virginia. Yeah. Shout out to Hampton.
Hey.
And I used to travel to JCPenney's, right? It's the only, like, major department store we had.
Right.
I think it was like that and some other that like, escapes me. And I used to buy Iman. Iman had a nude lipstick that I was obsessed with, but that was the only brand, like the only brand that focused on women of color.
Yeah, it's hard.
And you know, back then in college, you just wanted to act like you were like, you know, I'm not trying too hard, right? No one really wore red lipstick in college in the years that I was in college. So, you wanted to kind of have like a cute color. Iman was the only one.
Imagine that.
So imagine now you can actually go to how many different stores? You go to Target.
Absolutely. It's crazy how much tones for us. And it's like you have to keep reminding brands that it's not enough. You know, you have certain brands that may have 20 shades for Caucasians and then 3 for brown women.
Right.
And then it's like, well, we have range. No.
We have a lot of range.
Yes. Right. But we need to do a better job at creating more because there's so many hues of black too.
Right.
You know,
no,
like
absolutely.
We are women of color. We range so much.
Right.
We have different pigments, you know.
And even undertones, right?
Undertones.
So you have like, right.
Yes, I'm learning more about that too. But it's been a wonderful journey, you know, testing the colors, going to the factories with Nicole and really making sure that we were picking the right colors for what we thought was a need in the market.
Right. Now, do you manufacture here?
Yes, it's made in the U.S.
Okay, and it's vegan?
Yes.
Okay, so nobody's like, no rats are dying, right?
No one's dying. cruelty-free. That was a big part of it for me. And Nicole had done other cruelty-free lines, and she was like, you know, I want to stick to the integrity. And I'm like, I'm all about that. I want what's healthy for us. I don't want anyone to be harmed in the process. It's
been
really
nice.
Labor
so
of love.
Is your heart into beauty and makeup? What else? Are you doing anything else?
Yes. I mean, I love beauty and I'm learning more about it. So I want to educate myself more as I grow. Because everyone's like, well, we need foundations next and we need this. And I'm like, I want to learn more about beauty before I venture out too much. Lipstick was easy for me because it's like when I travel, that's my go-to.
Right, of course.
You know, I just pop a color on and keep it moving.
No, wait, I think I'm a complete makeup junkie. So
you are?
I mean, I don't even know how many lipsticks I have.
Oh, my God.
But I have two girls. I have two daughters, and they take all of my makeup. So I don't know what I have
What
anymore.
Ages are they?
6 and 4.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
I have to look out.
And every bit of 16 and 14. Oh. Every bit of it. Every bit of mommy's talking.
Uh-oh.
Like, behind my back. And I'm like,
oh, my God. I have so much to look forward to.
No, it's so scary. Oh, my God. It's so scary. But no. So they take all my lipstick. But, you know, I'm kind of like, what do you do?
Right.
Again,
right.
Like initially, I'm like, don't touch my stuff. Now I'm kind of like, whatever.
Yeah, let it go. Let it go.
It's like ends up everywhere, like on the floor, on the walls. And you're just kind of like, all right, what are you
going to
do?
Oh, boy. I have a 7-month-old daughter, so I'm definitely I'm going to get there.
I know. I'm so excited for you. Do you even have more? Or are you?
I do. But the thought of having another child now is like mind
blowing. Daunting, right?
Yes. I know. But I do.
If I could give any advice, I would say, have as many as you can before you get like comfortable with only having one.
Yes.
Because then you get like used to having one and you're not going to want to go back in.
I know. My mom said the same thing. I'm like, well, it's easy for you. You're the grandma. You have to bring her back home.
No, you kind of have to like just knock it out.
Knock it out.
Be done with it. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, I really want 3. And my partner is like, what did you just say?
I know. Listen, here we are. You have what you want, right?
Yes.
So what's next for you, Edwina? Like, so what are you working on? Outside of makeup, are you doing?
I mean, with the launch of this book, it's opened up a lot of global opportunities.
It's being released on November 27th.
November 27th, the Better Business Book. It's available on Amazon for pre-order if you want to get it now. But I think for me, being a global woman, you know, traveling, I speak 5.5 languages.
That's amazing.
I need to use that more.
I don't.
There's so many other markets that I want to enter, like Ghana, for example. You know, I speak Tri, I speak Ga, and there's so many young professionals out there that I could be
working with. Well, I have a few. We actually had Jude Henkofi on, and he's from Ghana
Yeah,
and he's in technology. And he's great. He also has a business in Ghana.
Okay.
He has 3 daughters.
Bless him.
He's an amazing guy. So I can introduce you all.
That would be great.
And his wife is also in beauty. But anyway, so I would love, and she's Ghanaian also.
Oh,
so I'm to hook you guys up.
I love meeting my people.
No, he's good people. We had a good time with him on the podcast. And he's brilliant, you know, so I think that you guys get on quite well.
I love brilliant people.
Yeah.
No, I think it goes in the lines of what I want to do. I want to connect more with people. I want to help brands. I want to help build businesses, whether they're domestic or global, supporting brands and sharing my expertise.
Right. Yeah. Okay. And how people can find you on IG?
Yes. At Edwina Kulego on IG.
Okay.
You can contact me very easily on my website as well.
And the brands. Do the brands have?
So the brand Essentials by Edwina, that's on Instagram at Essentials by Edwina. And then we also have Selfie Cosmetics, where you can get the products, selfiecosmetics.com and edwinakulego.com.
Okay. Perfect.
And I don't know if I should announce this yet, but we are working with a big retailer. I have to check in with Nicole and see if I can announce
this. Okay,
I'll follow up and announce
it. Hey, Nicole, you watching? Nicole, can she launch? Can she say it?
But we will be available worldwide as of next month, which
is so
really
exciting. Oh, congratulations.
So we partnered with an amazing retailer, and they ship worldwide. So anyone watching that wants the collection, you can finally get it, and I'll make an announcement on my personal page the Essentials page in a few weeks.
Super exciting.
Yay!
All right. Now, I guess, you know, a big reason, a big inspiration as to why we started this podcast is for people who just don't believe they can do it.
Right.
Right. So any kind of advice that you'd like to impart?
Yes, for sure. When I get to a stage where I'm like, can I do this? The thing that really reminds me that I can is the stuff that I've done in the past. So think about moments in your life when you didn't think you could do something, you did it. Then didn't think you can finish college, but you actually did. Or didn't think you could graduate with honors, and you did. Or didn't think you could graduate as a new mother, and you did. So I think a lot of the times we forget how strong we really are and how capable we are. So that's definitely one of the main things I do when I'm like, am I doubting myself? Okay, but I did something similar, or I watched my mom do this.
Right, right.
I can do this. Why not? Like, the worst answer you can get is no.
Right. And you know, so a lot of times you hear people say, well, I don't have the money. I don't have the money. I have to work. How do I, how did you get your financing?
I had support. I did have support internally from family. Right. I busted my butt. I worked, which I wasn't supposed to do when I was a student. Right. I worked I found a company in Queens that sold ATM machines, and I'm like, I'm looking for a job. What do you have? And they were awesome. Like, oh, you can come in these hours of the week. And I just started working.
You hustled.
I hustled. I was babysitting for a French family for a long time. And I just figured out, like, okay, what hours in my week outside of working and going to school, whatever it is that you're doing, find that pocket. And if it's 2 hours a day, okay, know that you have 2 hours a day to do something that can allow you to bring in more money. Find what that thing is, right. Whether it's working somewhere or selling a product online. I mean, now we have opportunities that we didn't have before.
Absolutely.
Right?
I mean, you can do anything online now, right?
Yes, you can do so many things online. You know, sell products, have it drop shipped where you don't even touch what's happening behind the scenes. If you have a service, sometimes we forget to look in the mirror. Like, if you speak multiple languages, maybe you can work as a translator. Right. You know, I have another friend from Sweden who was like, I don't know what I'm going to do. I need to figure out how to make more money. And I'm like, well, you speak French, you speak Spanish, find a French or Spanish company a family that's looking for a babysitter or nanny to help teach their children that language.
Absolutely.
I mean,
that's
people
amazing.
Will pay a premium
I would still pay a premium for it.
Yes.
So if you know anybody, let me know.
Yes. I mean, there's sometimes we forget what we're capable of.
What you actually, what services you actually possess without even thinking that you have them.
Right. 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 Copywriting, If you're a good writer, or I don't know. I mean, Uber, come on.
Right. There's a million ways to make money.
There are so many ways to make money. There's a post, and I have to find it and share it with you and your audience, that I found on Instagram, and it was like how to create income in like easy ways. Like, I think one of them was become an Uber driver, or you know, start placing ATMs and, you know, make a surcharge for every transaction. Like, obviously you need capital
to
do those
things. Once upon a year, I had ATM machines. And
really?
And we placed them.
Look at that.
In beauty salons.
See?
We would make money at the surcharges. Yeah.
Yes. If you find areas that are lacking those machines, you might end up making a lot of money.
The only reason why we stopped is that we started getting so scared of having to refill the machines, because they were in like pretty urban areas, and then by the time you tried to figure out how to hire a security guard to help you with the cash, but you're taking out so much cash,
it's dangerous,
and it's just dangerous.
Yeah,
so we would come on different modes of transportation. Like, one day I come on a bike, and like with a hoodie,
so they would see you.
They could identify like when the money was coming. It was a debacle, but.
See, but you hustle.
But yeah, no, I mean, you have to try to figure out different ways to get the money, get to the money, right?
Yes, for sure.
And it's business, it's entrepreneurship. So even though that failed, it was still, I mean, it's a hilarious story.
That's a great story.
Right.
But it inspires someone.
Right, no, exactly. So
There are many ways, and you just have to be creative. I feel like when you're down and when you don't have much, when you're in a tough spot, that's when your mind really starts getting to a creative space. Because when you're comfortable, you're just like, oh, okay, well, I'll just sit here and I don't have
making
to
this
think.
Right, right.
So I've been in corporate for 8 years, and I'm still in corporate, which a lot of people are like, did you leave UBM? No, I'm still there. I'm still managing our international business development. But, you know, after a while, I was looking at myself and I was like, you're getting comfortable.
Right.
And there's so many other things you could be doing. And that's when I, you know, just started networking and I started doing more public speaking and sharing what I knew and meeting other people. And then other opportunities opened up and then I started getting a bunch of press. And then I was like, well, what could I do with this? And then the makeup line came.
Right.
And now the book and, you know.
And now you're about to be in a major retailer.
I know. That, yeah. So it just, yeah, you kind of have to keep together,
right.
It does, and keep pushing.
Even in doubt. So even like, yes. And so you're still doubtful, right? You still have doubt every day, but yes. You still move in doubt, right?
Move through it, push through it. And some days it's hard. You know, we hear a lot of like positive motivation all the time. And sometimes when you are down and when you don't have much, it's hard to be like, well, I have to be positive.
Right,
you know?
Right.
Sometimes you feel like shit and that's okay.
And you allow yourself to be negative that day.
Yes.
But then, keep it limited to that day.
Yes.
Like don't stay in that funk. Right.
Stay in the funk.
Right,
you know,
right.
Stay
it's
at home.
Terrible. It's super like nasty out. But I voted. Yeah, we voted, right?
Exactly.
But it's a terrible day out. And so this is like the perfect day to kind of stay in the house and just be negative.
Yes.
Right.
But, you know, you have your days and that's okay. I'm not going to lie and pretend that I'm always like, well, I always find a way out of no way.
Yeah.
Some days I'm stuck.
Right.
And when you're stuck, you become creative. And
it's
when
so
you're
true.
Stuck, you start thinking, well, what else can I do? When you're stuck, you call your friends and they give you a brilliant idea. And then all of a sudden,
right.
You're inspired.
And you think it's a coincidence, but it's not.
Right.
And so, I had the advantage of seeing Arianna Huffington in some lecture at CBS, at Columbia Business School.
Mm-hmm.
And she was like, you know, when you get a nag and you get a pull, like honor the pull.
Right.
Like stop trying to ignore the pull, like honor it. You
yes.
know, like why am I being pulled in this direction? What is this?
Mm-hmm.
Like explore it as opposed to just saying, oh.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And that resonated with me because I'm just kind of like, yeah, no, honor the pull. If
absolutely.
You're getting pulled, it's being like, so you're Nicole.
Yes, exactly.
Nicole. Like,
everyone
why am I being pulled towards
name.
Nicole? Like, what is this?
Yes.
And you honored it.
I honored it. And now
and
look.
Look at this. It's so cool. I got goosebumps. I got goosebumps.
It's a beautiful
it's so
story.
Good. No, it's great.
We just vibe. Like, she's just another go-getter. She started Selfie years ago. Where there wasn't beauty companies like hers in the market. And she's been through a lot. Like, we'll sit down and she'll tell me trials, tribulations. She had her company taken away from her by investors. She had to open up a new company with a completely new name in order
wow.
to keep going. Like, she is one of those women where I'm like, she could have easily thrown her hands up and been like, well, I'm going back to corporate because
right.
this crazy.
Is not, yeah.
And she's still pushing and we're working together and I'm learning a lot through her. So I think it's great to have a partner in business.
Yeah,
a lot of people ask, well, why didn't you do it yourself? And why? No, this collaboration is great for me because I'm honest in the fact that I don't know beauty as well as she does.
Right.
So if I can have someone by my side helping
can educate
me,
you, right.
Yes. And then I can support her on the global side. Now we're in Ghana. We're going to be in Nigeria. We're in Sweden. We're in
awesome.
Denmark. We're in Norway. So, you know, you
so
got to
support
each other.
So what do you say to the naysayers? Because I'm sure you.
Bye, haters. That's one of the things I say to
them.
Right. You know, when you.
Sometimes the naysayers are a little bit closer than you can't just say bye to them because
right.
they're actually in your family.
Listen, in your family around you, pretending to support you. I think that. When people are in a funk, when they don't see opportunities, when they failed, it's
right.
easy to be like, well, you can't do that. And well, who do you think you are? And why are you starting a beauty line?
Right.
Do you think you're a model or something?
Right.
You know,
oh
you
my
hear
God.
All kinds
the,
of
oh
things.
Oh God, the terrible things.
Yes.
People say. Right.
Well, I don't get it. What is it? I don't get it. You know, and you just have to kind of
let it brush off.
Brush it off, but also look at that person and see them for where they are in their life. You know, some people just can't be happy for you because they're not happy.
Right.
And I think once I started realizing that it had everything to do with them and not with me,
right.
I was cool. I was cool as a fan.
Right,
I started
right.
getting upset. I started getting angry. And I just kind of, you just see people for where they are. Pray for them, bless them, child,
right.
and keep getting your bag.
Can you say that in like a different language? Because I want to hear that like a different language.
Hmm. Okay, let's see if I can say that in Swedish. What did I just say? När du har folk, människor runt omkring dig som är negativa, som inte försöker supporta dig eller hjälpa dig, säg hej då till dem, fortsätt tjäna dina pengar, get your bag, honey bun, and keep it moving.
I love it. So for our Swedish audience.
Yeah, shout out to Sweden.
Shout out to Sweden. We're going to actually try to pump this up in Sweden.
Yes, right? Yes, for sure.
So, and you can tell us where we should publish, because you are going to help us with international business.
Absolutely. Right. Yes. Now my mind's going. I need to start thinking about where we should put this out.
But that's a brilliant idea. I'm all ears.
Dingata radio station. I'm going to be calling you guys.
Yeah, that.
That part.
No, that part. All right. Well, I mean, I think that we can probably go on forever.
Yes.
But we should probably, quit for this time. Because next, I want to have you back after the launch of the major retailer so we can talk about it.
Yes. And I want to share it. I'm not sure if I can. But it actually, it's a company that really inspired me in the beginning of my journey. So the fact that I'm getting to work with them now is amazing.
Serendipity. It was meant to be.
It was so meant to be. And when I called my mom and I was like, we got the contract. She was like, what? She was like, look at God. I'm like, this is godsend.
Right. Yes. And she must be so proud, like considering where her shop is, right? And now you're like running.
And I never thought I would. And I go home and she has like posters of the campaign photos in the store. Nice. And I'm like, Mom, you could take it down now. Like,
that's so nice.
It's been a year.
She's live. No, she loves it. She loves it. I put it up too.
Yeah, she's amazing. I love you, mommy.
Oh, awesome.
Yay.
Okay. Well, thanks, guys, for tuning in to another episode of Unexpected Success with me, Joy. Yay. I'm so happy, Edwina. I'm so happy you joined us.
Thank you so much. And thank you for doing this, for everyone tuning in and for people like me who love just listening and getting inspired by other people. Thank you for creating this platform.
Well, I hope people are listening. But until you have to build it first. Right? Yes. You build it first. So you can find us on iTunes, Spotify, iHeart, YouTube, and Podbean. Please hit subscribe and leave a review. We're going to post the reviews and read the reviews. Until next time, Edwina, keep winning.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Likewise.
To you. And thank you. Until next time.
Bye, guys. Thanks for having me.
Yay.
This is great.
I'm so happy.
This podcast was brought to you by 23DB Productions, ID Productions, and One of One Productions. For more information, go to Facebook and Instagram, Unexpected Success with Joy.